The next is the name of Allah, Al-Hayy. Notice this is different from Al-Hayy. Al-Hayy is the ever-living. This is Al-Hayy. There's two ya's over here. And Al-Hayy is the one who has haya, meaning the one who is very modest, the one who is very shy. This name of Allah appears in the Sunnah. It doesn't occur in the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna rabbakum tabaraka wa ta'ala hayyun kareemun yastahyi min 'abdihi." That your Lord, the Blessed and Exalted, is modest and generous. Hayy, he is ever modest. Kareem, he is ever generous. يستحيي من عبده, he is shy of his slave. إذا رفع يديه إليه أن يردهما صفرا. That when the slave raises his hands before Allah, begging him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shy to return them empty-handed, meaning he would never return such hands of his slave without gain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put something in those hands. He will give something to his servants. So we see in this hadith that the name of Allah, Hayy, is mentioned. Haya, like I mentioned, Hayy is one who has haya. And haya, generally we translate it as, you know, modesty or shyness. Haya is basically to feel, it's described as a shrinking of the soul from foul conduct. Okay, meaning that when that basically a person feels apprehension or uncomfortable, very uneasy about doing something that they believe is unpleasant, right? That they believe is wrong, that they believe is incorrect. Why they shrink from it? They have apprehension towards it. Out of fear of blame, right? Or out of that belief that, you know, this is something wrong. So haya is basically that feeling within a person which prevents them from doing what is wrong. It prevents them from exceeding what is acceptable, right? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, in a hadith we learned, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. That when you don't have haya, when you don't have shyness, then do whatever you want. Why? Because shyness, haya, it withholds you, it prevents you, it stops you from foul conduct, right? From doing what is wrong. And when a person does not have haya, then they basically do whatever they want. They basically say whatever they want. So hayy is one who has haya. Now remember that when it comes to shyness, right, or shame, there is a healthy expression of shame or haya, and there's an unhealthy expression of shame or haya. A healthy expression of haya, for example, is that out of haya, a person does not, you know, say rude words, okay? Or that the way that a person talks to others, they are respectful. Why? Out of shyness. They're too shy to use foul language, okay? An unhealthy expression of haya is, for example, out of shame, out of shyness, a person does not recite Quran, right? Or does not, pray Salah because, oh, others are going to watch me and it's too embarrassing. So you see, haya is that feeling from inside that's going to prevent you from doing something. There's a healthy aspect of it and there's an unhealthy aspect of it. So when we're talking about haya, we're, that is praiseworthy or that we're supposed to have, then it's always the praiseworthy one. It's always the healthy one. All right. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy, what does that mean? I want you to think about this hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah is hayy and he is too shy to return, the slaves of his servant empty-handed. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always puts something in the raised hands of his slave. So remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's haya is haya of generosity. Okay? Meaning, he is hayy, so he is not stingy. Rather, he is generous. He is hayy, so he is not, harsh and unfair. Rather, he is compassionate towards his servants. He is hayy, which is why he shows pardon to his servants. He is hayy, meaning he is shy to, or meaning he would not, reject the istighfar of his servants. Rather, he would pardon them. He would show mercy to them, and he would show compassion towards them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's haya is not like the haya of people. It is the haya of generosity. Okay, it is the haya of compassion, pardon, and mercy. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy, it means that he is kathirul haya, right? So he continues to give, he continues to, conceal the sins of his slaves, and he continues to spare his servants also, where he keeps giving them chances, right? And he keeps, concealing their sins so that they realize and they turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy, what does that mean for us? This means that we should also have haya, because Allah is hayy and he also likes haya. And remember that when it comes to haya, we must learn what the proper expression of haya is. Okay, sometimes what happens is that we think haya is just in, clothing, or haya is, just in, a woman being hidden always, right? Haya is more than just that. Haya, we see, the right expression of haya is that a person is shy to be verbally abusive. A person is shy to, do what is wrong or to say what is wrong. We learn in the Quran that إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَحْيِي أَن يَضْرِبَ مَثَلًا مَا بَعُوضَةً فَمَا فَوْقَهَا, that indeed Allah is not shy to give the example of a mosquito or what is more insignificant than that. Meaning Allah is not shy of the truth, right? وَاللَّهُ لَا يَسْتَحْيِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ, Allah is not shy of the truth. So we should have haya, but that haya should not mean that we are too shy to speak the truth, to believe in the truth, to live the truth. Then we see that, once some people came in the gathering of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one person, he came forward, and he found a spot and he sat there all the way at the front. Another person, he just sat at the back. Another person, he came and he was too shy and he left, right? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the third person that fastahya fastahya Allahu minhu, when he was too shy, meaning as a result of his shyness he did not come forward, he turned away, then Allah also turned away from him. So we should have the right kind of shyness, not shyness that prevents us from doing what is right. And then we see that Sulaym radiallahu anha, she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once and she said that Allah is not shy of the truth, right? Inna Allah la yastahi min al-haq, Allah is not shy of the truth. And then she asked a question. So, meaning it was a very awkward question, but she wanted to know what the truth was. So she began with the statement that Allah is not shy of the truth. So I want to learn what the truth is about this matter, what the right thing to do is. So we should have haya, but the right kind of haya, meaning its expression should be in the right place and in the right way. In a hadith, we learned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that innal haya'a al-afafu wal-iyya, that haya, afaf and iyyul lisani la iyyul qalb. It is the ri of the tongue, not that of the heart. Meaning that modesty, abstinence, and restraint. Okay? Modesty, abstinence, and restraint. This is the restraint of the tongue, not of the heart. All right? Not of the heart. Meaning, in your heart, you're supposed to have, the right iman. Right, you believe in the truth, you're passionate about it, but what restraint means is that you restrain your tongue, right? That shyness should prevent you from saying what is inappropriate, from saying what is wrong. And you know, sometimes we become so aggressive in talking to people, in advising people, so aggressive and so rude and so shameless in the way that we talk to people. You know, we have heard a few things, we have read a few lines, and we think that we know everything, and we are, you know, the most learned, and our judgment concerning certain matters is the absolute ultimate truth, and everyone must adhere to that. And then we start imposing it on people, and we come across as so, you know, aggressive and harsh and rude. And this is not correct, because restraint is supposed to be in the tongue. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy, we should also have haya, the right kind of haya, meaning we should express it in the right way. Secondly, we should have haya of Allah. We should have haya of Allah, meaning we should remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us, right? That there is no place, no time when we can hide from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا تَكُونُ فِي شَأْنٍ وَمَا تَتْلُو مِنْهُ مِنْ قُرْآنٍ وَلَا تَعْمَلُونَ مِنْ عَمَلٍ إِلَّا كُنَّا عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا. That you are not in any state, meaning no matter what state you're in, no matter what portion of the Quran you recite, no matter what deed you are performing, except that we are witnesses over you. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing, He is watching you, you know, in whatever state that you're in, you are being watched by Allah. So have haya of Allah, right? Have shyness of Allah, that my Lord is watching me. In a hadith, we learned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to a man that I advise you to be modest in front of Allah as you would be modest in front of a righteous man among your people. Meaning, how would you behave if a righteous person appeared before you? You would become so polite, so careful, you know, so deliberate, so kind. You know, you would start making dhikr. You know, you would guard your eyes. You would become so careful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always watching you. Have haya of Allah as well. Then we learned that once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that be modest before Allah as is his right. So the people said, O Messenger of Allah, we are modest before Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, rather, modesty before Allah as is his right is that you guard the head and whatever that runs through it. Okay? You guard the head and whatever that it contains, meaning that whatever goes through your mind, right, your thoughts, you guard them. What is on your head? You have your ears, you have your eyes, right? You have your mouth. So what are you doing? What are you listening to? What are you saying? What are you looking at? Have haya of Allah with regards to what you are listening to, what you're saying, what you're looking at, what you're thinking. Have haya of Allah. And then he said, and guard the stomach and what it contains, what fills the stomach. Meaning, what are you eating? Where are you getting that from? How much are you eating? Right? How excessively are you eating? How greedily are you eating? Did you even thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it? And to reflect upon death and trials. Right? So this is to have the right kind of haya with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy, it also means that we should keep calling upon Allah. Because when Allah is al-hayy, as we learn in the hadith, he is shy to return the slave's hands empty-handed, right? Meaning he will definitely give the slave something. So always ask Allah, always call upon him. And what that means is that even if you are not going to be given right away what you asked for, right? You're going to be given something. You're going to be given something. And what could that something be? It could be something better. It could be something lesser. It could be the immediate reward of, you know, remembering Allah, of talking to Allah, of making dua, of worshiping Allah, of obeying His command that you know, you should make dua. Allah will give you something. So never hesitate and never stop calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah is Al-Hayy, the one who is shy, the one who is modest, the one who is ever generous, ever compassionate. So be hopeful and keep calling upon Allah.